Interested in leveling up your Notion workspace and pages beyond the basic database views? In this video, we wanted to show you 5 different techniques that you can use to become a Notion power user, from basic formulas, sub-items, relations, and more. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. If you're new to formulas, we just wanted to give you some basic formulas to start with. So in this case, we have a table of a book and how many pages you've read and the total number of pages. The first formula we wanted to show you by clicking this plus sign and then looking for formula is how to format your database property entries in 2 different ways. So we're going to show you the style formula. So we're going to click edit. And let's say that you wanted to show the pages read in a more fancy way, then you can type style, and then you could add the pages read like this. And then you can add different styling options, which are outlined here. So you can do things like change it to pink, red, purple, bold, and so on. So let's say that we want it to be bold and in blue, we could do something like this. And then what could be good, if you click done, is now we see the number 5 in blue and in bold, is that what if you want to also show the pages read in text as well? You can type plus sign here and then put another 2 quotation marks and then put a space and then you can type pages read. And this way you can give a little bit more context than simply a number here, which can be really nice, for example, also inside of gallery view databases. The next formula we wanted to show you is the if statement. So let's say that you want to show a message if you've only read less than 10 pages of a book. You can click the plus sign here and then look for formula, and we're going to click edit. So this formula, let's say we want to use if. So if the number of pages read, so pages read is less than 10, then what we can do is show a text here, keep reading. And if not, we can keep it blank. So then if we click done, we can see keep reading. But if we put a number over 10, like 15, it's not going to show any message. If you wanted to show a new message, if it's over 10 pages read, then you could do something like good job, keep reading. So in this way, you can have this formula show different things based on if statements, which are usually conditional. So if we go back again, you can see that if pages read is less than 10, we show keep reading. If it's over 10, which means this is false, then it's going to show good job, keep reading. The next formula we wanted to show you is a date formula. So if we go ahead and type formula here, what we're going to do for this one is to show how many days it's been since you started reading the book. So for that, we actually need another property in this database called date. So we're going to go ahead and add a date property and we're going to write date started. And let's say that the date started was the 15th of August. So then what you can do is do a date between formula, and we're going to put the date between now and the date started like this, and then we want to see it in days. So in this case, now you see the days 8, and then we can click done. So here this would be days since starting. So you can do interesting calculations like this with the date between formula. And another thing is you can also calculate it based on months or years, even hours and minutes. So this date between formula is very useful. The final formula we wanted to show you is a round function. And this is something we get asked quite often. And since we have 15 pages out of 100, if we wanted to show a progress bar showing how many pages percentually that you've read, you can click plus here and then we can add another formula. And this formula is going to divide the pages read by the total pages. And we can click done. And then what we can do is do the number format to show percent. So now we see 15%. And that's great if you have an easy number like this. But let's say that we have 255 pages and we've read 3. You can see that the percentage looks very complicated, and this is when it's really useful to do a round function. So if we go ahead and type round, you can use this formula. And the issue with this formula is that it tends to round to the integer. So instead, what we need to do is to multiply this division by 100 by doing something like this and then dividing it by 100. And this ensures that you have a better rounding system. So as you can see now, it's 1%. So if we put something like 33, it's 13%. So this is a really useful way to round up your formulas. So be sure to try out the round function if you're trying to achieve cleaner percentages. Subitems are a really great way to see your items inside of your databases broken down into smaller pieces. So this is particularly useful if you have a task database. So let's say that we have task 1, task 3, like this, and you have subtasks that you want to show up here without creating another database. Then what you can do is go to the three dots here, and then you can go to the customize database option here, and then add sub items, and then turn on sub items. So now you could do something like sub item 1, sub item 2, and so on. And this makes it a bit easier to see your sub items from your main items. And it also retains the same properties that you have for your main item here. So you can also add different tags here as well. So this can be really useful if you have the same sort of category items that you want to make into sub items. The next thing we wanted to show you is dependencies. So dependencies are a really useful feature if you want to show the way that items interact with each other inside of your databases. So let's say that you have a project here, project 1, and you have another project here, project 2. And if you don't finish project 1, there's no way to start project 2. You can add a dependency by connecting it like this. And this is really useful when you have a timeline view database, as it's really clear the dependencies. And when you do select this, you can choose various options like shift only when dates overlap, shift maintain time between items, and do not automatically shift. You can also add things like avoiding weekends. So we can go ahead and turn it on. And when something does have a dependency, you'll notice that there is the block by and blocking options. And dependencies can also be added no matter what kind of database view you have. So if we go ahead and add a table view here, you can still see block by and blocking. And if you want to add something like this, you will have to go to the customized database, and then you can go ahead and turn on dependencies, which is already on here. So if you are in a table view as opposed to timeline view, you will have to add it manually. But if you're in the timeline view, you can simply drag the arrow to show these kinds of dependencies. Next, we wanted to show you a bit about relations with databases. And this is something that can be confusing for first-time Notion users. So we wanted to break it down in a way that's a little bit easier to understand. So for a relation to work, you will need 1 to 2 databases. Most often, you will connect 2 databases together. In this case, we'll show you relations by having 2 databases first. And let's take the example where you might have a recipe database and you have an ingredients database. So let's say that you have a recipe here for avocado toast, and the ingredients here are going to be avocado and toast. And once you have that, what you might want to do is add a relation to the ingredients database so you can see what kind of ingredients you need for avocado toast. So let's go ahead and click the plus button here, and then we're going to do relation. Once you click relation, you can relate it to the ingredients database. And what we recommend you to do is toggle on show on ingredients database so that you know exactly the relations going on in your systems. And you can also turn on or off no limit. So if you only can allow 1 ingredient, you would want this to be 1 page. But if you can have multiple ingredients, you can put no limit. So let's go ahead and turn this on and then add relation. So as soon as you add that, you'll notice that the ingredients database shows up here and the recipe database shows up here. So let's go ahead and add our avocado and toast into the ingredients database property here. So we have avocado and we have toast. So now you can see the 2 ingredients required to make avocado toast, and also the ingredients now knows what kind of recipe you can make with an avocado. So these are really useful ways to use it. And the other option, if you're trying to do a relation, is to relate it to itself. So let's say that you want to show that avocado toast goes really well with a tomato soup. So then here you can put food pairing, as a relation. So we can put relation and we can relate it back to the recipe database like this. And we can call this one best food pairing. And then let's say that here we want to show that it's good with tomato soup. And then here you can see that tomato soup is good with avocado toast. So in this way, you can also add a relation that relates back to its own database. Then the next thing that we wanted to show regarding relations is that it makes it easier to do calculations inside of another database to show up inside, for example, the recipe database. So let's say that we have a number property here that's going to show the pricing. And we can choose, for example, US dollar. And let's say that a bag of avocados costs $4 and the toast bag is gonna cost $3. So what you can do is just calculate the amount that the ingredients are gonna cost for you by doing something called rollup. So if we click plus here and then go to rollup, we can choose the relation. So we want to relate it to the ingredients database here and then see the property. So the properties are here, which is the pricing. And now you'll see that it's $4 and $3. And what we can do is calculate by going to more options, sum. So now you can see that it total ingredient cost is $7. So we're gonna put total ingredient cost. So this is a bit more advanced techniques, but it definitely helps to start using relations and rollups to get an even better system working where you have multiple databases in Notion. Then the next thing we wanted to show you are database templates. And this is also a really useful feature if you haven't started using it already. So if you already have a journal database here and every day you write a daily journal like this, and you open it up and then you can type your daily journal inside here, but you always have the same 5 questions, such as what happened today, what were the highlights, and so on. And you don't want to keep typing this every day for your daily journal. What you can do is create a database template. So let's go ahead and highlight this and copy it. And then we can go to this button here and do plus new template. So this is a daily journal template. And we can go ahead and paste these in. You can even pre-add a tag. So if this is a daily journal, you can do something like this and then click out. So now when you click a new journal entry, you open it up, you can see the daily journal template, and it's just going to show everything up here like this. If you always wanted to show a daily journal template, you can also set it as a default. So to do that, you can click this 3 dots here and then set as default for all views and journals. So anything you create new is always going to be a daily journal. And then the last thing we wanted to show you is that if you want this to show up every day at a certain designated time, you can click the 3 dots here and then set it on repeat daily. And then you can set up a time that works for you that you wanted to show up here. So database templates can be really useful for things like meeting notes, or even if you have multiple kinds of journals that you want a special template for. So not only daily journal, you could also add a new template, which is maybe a monthly journal entry. And then you could have different things inside of here as well that you can choose from. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.